A wild Nero puppy appears. He uses his charm attack. And then walks away.
I can't believe him. He just doesn't play along when I want to make a video.
He says, no, Daddy. You gotta pay me for these appearances.
It just won't happen for free. Payment in dog biscuits and runs around the house. Because that's what he likes. Those are two of his favorite things. We actually went to the beach recently. My goodness. Did he have a good time? You don't have to answer that.
Because he really did. He had an amazing time. I think it's probably the most tired that he's ever been in his life.
He just ran and ran and ran and ate sand and jumped in the water and then ran some more. It was, you know, pretty good. But the sand eating, that wasn't intentional.
So are you guys busy signing up for the Guild Wars 2 beta? Oh my goodness. Sign-up's open for the next couple of hours.
By the time this vlog goes up, probably like, you've got like 3 or 4 hours maybe. Because I'm busy uploading...
What am I uploading?
Skyrim? Oh my, Skyrim's good. Skyrim's a lot of fun.
Look at that face.
Oh, my boy. My boy.
Hello. I want your paw. Oh, look at him. That's a happy dog face right there. He's happy. He's content. But now he's checking his rope out. Here, boy. This is your baby rope.
He's just so nice, isn't he?
He's looking like that, so out of breath, because he was actually lying out there in the sun. It's blisteringly hot.
I don't know why he'd do that, but he does. He does do that all the time.
So, back to the Guild Wars 2, though. Sign-up's open. You can sign up right here on the website. I think it's beta.guildwars2.com.
And you have to just run a little thingy on your computer, so it takes your PC's specs. And it submits it to them, and they said they're going to choose testers based on their needs, basically. So I'm assuming they're going to choose some mid-range, some low-range, some high-range PCs, some super high-range PCs. Mine will probably be in the mid-range, because it's not so good. It's okay. I'll run it on that old computer over there, if it even makes the minimum requirements. But, you know, sign up with all your email addresses. If you've got more than one, I've got like 6 for some reason. I've got like 3 or 4 maybe, but I've got a couple, okay? So it's open, and I don't know if I'm going to get in. Are you guys going to get in? Do any of you have plans? Like, you know, planning on getting in? Because I would like to. I've emailed a few people about press invites and stuff, and it seems like they're slightly more open to that kind of thing now. The first beta was very exclusive, as a lot of you know. Big people didn't get in. We spoke about this in the last vlog, but... I think this time around it's going to be a lot easier to get in. They're going to accept a lot more people. It looks like things are moving forward a lot faster than I expected them to.
Goodness. Someone's here.
Someone's here. What? Hold that thought. Did you just hold that thought for like 3 or 4 hours? It's afternoon already.
Nero's still here though. He's looking very sad now. He wants to go for a walk.
I didn't mean to say that. No.
We'll go later, okay? We'll go later. Yes, it's okay.
Oh man, that was close. That was super close. Lucky I managed to play it down. It's too late though. The seed has been planted. So I've totally forgotten what I was talking about, because what happened now, it's actually quite good, is that our internet's finally been activated. If you look down there, that's a router. It's actually plugged into Riot Panda's PC right here. Okay. Cable's going up there behind the TV into a PC. So the second line is now, or should now be active, which means, I'm going to be able to upload a lot more. Okay? Now, there's going to be a bit of a problem with this. And I'm getting sidetracked because there was like a ton of stuff I needed to talk about. And I'm going to talk about it. I will talk about it. If this vlog ends up being 15 minutes or 20 minutes long, then that's just too bad. Okay? That's too bad. You guys are going to have to suffer through it. So, what that's going to mean over there, that thing over there, is that I'm going to be able to upload a lot more Skyrim and Revelations, maybe, because I'll just have them permanently running on the one line and then have all the other stuff on the other line. But the problem is YouTube's publishing system sucks. It really does. YouTube, if you're watching this, which you probably are, because you probably watch all your videos, then you should fix it. You should do something about it, because it publishes the video at the time that you start the upload. So if I upload something that's 1.5 gigs big, 1.5 gigs, then that means that it'll be published when I started the upload. So if I start that now, let's say it might be done tomorrow morning early, then it's going to publish it now, tomorrow morning. So it publishes the video in the past. That's messed up. It's difficult to understand, but that's how it works. So that doesn't really affect people with super fast internet. I've explained this like 1,000 times, but I'm doing it again. It doesn't affect people with super fast internet because their uploads start and finish within a short amount of time. But with me, it's like 12 hours, so it's not quite as easy. But I'll live with it. And what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be uploading a lot of what you may have missed videos. So like weekly recaps. I think that's probably the best way of doing it. They take a little bit of time to set up because I need to put annotations all over them, but I think they're very effective. So you can check that out, you can see the videos you've missed, and you can just click on the annotations, they'll open in new windows, and that's that. Because the thing is, you might actually miss videos. The reason for that, because, you know, it's uploaded in the past. It's terrible. But you might miss videos because they'll appear very far down in your timeline. It all depends on how many people you subscribe to. If you only subscribe to me and like one or two other people, then the chances are slim that you're actually going to miss something. But if you subscribe to like 10 plus people, 30 plus people, I think I'm subscribed to like 300 people, then you tend to miss videos every now and then. I think if you pin me on the side of your YouTube bar, then you'll see the uploads more regularly, or there's a better chance that you'll see them, but who knows? Okay, who knows? But I had to say that, the line is there, and it's got the same upload speed as I've got right now. So I've got double the upload speed, which means I can theoretically upload double as much. We'll have to see how it works in practice, and I'm going to be doing it on her PC, because we've only got these two that actually work properly. And she's not going to enjoy that very much, but she's going to have to live with it. It's too bad. It really is. But there was more that I wanted to talk about. So we spoke about the Guild Wars 2 beta, right there, you see. Sign up. Right now, do it. Hopefully you can get a spot in the beta. And hopefully I will too, because I'm super keen for that. Then, in the next tab, we've got Counter-Strike Global Offensive. They actually put a survey up that you can fill out, and then you'll be considered for the beta. They got some questions in there. They take your PC specs via Steam, and you can play in that beta as well. Apparently they're also ramping things up. It's quite an exciting month, isn't it? They're really going all out in February. I don't even know why. I don't know why. Are you on your way, my boy? You just go catch some sun, okay? Let's watch him for a second. Let's just watch him. Shh. He doesn't like being watched. I was just checking the shame. Purposefully just not lying down and relaxing, because he knows I'm filming him. Now I feel guilty about doing that. That's okay. So, you can sign up for that as well. I'll actually put links to both of these below. This is like a news episode, isn't it? I'll put links to both the sign-up pages below and the other stuff that I'm going to talk about, because there's actually a lot of stuff to talk about. Terraria devs have stopped working on Terraria. They're done. A lot of people are misunderstanding this. They see, like, there are a lot of headlines going up like Terraria dies, or it's the end of Terraria and blah blah blah. That's not true, okay? The game is good. You can still buy it for like $5 or whatever, it's probably $10 on Steam, and there's a ton of content. There's actually more content than there is in Minecraft, if you just get the game like that, obviously. Minecraft has a lot more user-generated stuff, that's fine, but I think eventually Terraria will also get a lot of stuff like that. Although I don't think the game supports mods and packs and stuff like that as well as Minecraft does, but there's still the potential for that. So, I don't have the article open over there, but they are moving on. The Terraria devs say that, you know, while it was a great game to work on and all that, they just have other plans. I think the one lead developer has a son that he wants to spend time with, and I totally understand that. You've also seen that TIY guy or girl, I don't know if it's a guy or girl, but that person started their own game, which is called Starbound, which also looks quite cool, very Terraria-ish, but it's still a bit of a shocker, isn't it, that they're just stopping development. They said they're going to release one more patch, which is going to contain bug fixes and stuff like that, but after that, they're done. The game is going to be what the game is for years to come. So, I mean, that's okay. I mean, my Terraria series was bound to end someday, but I'll just replace it with something even better. Shouldn't be too difficult. It's probably going to be quite difficult. If find it something better than Terraria, or as good as Terraria. We'll have to wait and see. Okay, but there's still a lot to do in Terraria, so I'm not in a rush at all. And that was that. It's not there. I don't know why I keep pointing the camera there. It's not there right now. And then the last thing I wanted to talk about was the amazing Mass Effect trailer. Take Back the Earth. I think it was called Take Back the Earth. That was so, so cool. It's like a little movie. Okay. I should have had popcorn ready for that. And I should have like dimmed the lights and put it on our TV and just enjoyed that. Sat down and enjoyed that. But then it ended too fast because it was so good and I didn't realize that it was good. I can't wait for that game. And tying in with that, did you guys see Total Biscuit's video on the Day 1 DLC with Mass Effect? I would say it's a pretty big deal, and it's not cool that they did that. I don't know if it's going to stop me from playing the game, because I actually ordered, and I'll tell you now, I ordered the Collector's Edition of Mass Effect, and the really sad thing is that I'm going to be getting the Collector's Edition on the 10th. The 10th. Oh! I can't believe that. I'm going to like record vlogs from the 6th till the 10th, like 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, and then on the 10th. Every day I'll record a vlog and just tell you guys how depressed I am that I'm not playing the game yet. I'll do that. I don't even care. I'll do that. I'll make a countdown vlogs. Make them like really short. And I'll make like a 10-second vlog where I'm just looking at the camera and looking totally sad. By day 3, I'll probably be crying already. Oh, it'd be terrible. So I'm getting it like 4 days after the rest of the world. I think the Europeans amongst us, everyone except the Americans, probably getting it on the 9th or the 10th anyway. But I'm getting it on that Friday, the 10th. And the reason I ordered the Collector's Edition is not because I'm rich. No, because for some reason, the local websites here had a special on the Collector's Edition. And they were selling it. I can actually tell you the reason. I'll tell you in just a second. They were selling it for 360 Rand. So if you work that out in dollars, it's about 360 Rand, it's about $40, $43, $40, I don't know, around there, okay, just over $40. How cheap is that? That's ridiculously cheap, and that's the retail version, the boxed version. So I'm actually getting the box with all the goodies in it, the poster, the book, the soundtrack, the stuff, all of it, and they were selling it for way too cheap, and I took advantage of that. I ordered it, and I've paid already, so they can't come afterwards and charge me extra. That's just not going to happen. So I'm very happy about that. I'm super excited, and I think the reason they're doing that is because they're just not getting the sales they wanted. People don't buy boxed version of games anymore. The only games that I buy are these ones. Okay, we buy Blizzard games, collector's editions. I like having my collector's edition of Blizzard games. Like we only recently started doing it, but I will definitely get the Heart of the Swarm collector's edition and the Mists of Pandaria collectors. Just because it'll be cool, you know, they give such nice stuff with it. They give you those extras that'll work for all their games. Oh, and the Diablo 3 Collector's Edition, that I'll get for sure. I've actually ordered it already. I can't wait for that either. But that's pretty much all I wanted to talk about. Expect more videos in the coming days. There might be a little bit of a delay now till I get everything up and running. But expect a lot more videos. Hopefully I'll be able to get a lot more Assassin's Creed and Skyrim out before Mass Effect starts. But the cool thing is that I'll be able to do Mass Effect quite easily now because the second line is up. And that's thanks to you guys. Well, mostly thanks to you guys at least. So thank you for the donations. It's amazing. Thank you for voting in King of the Web. That's actually really sad because in King of the Web, the two guys or three guys above me, I'm 13th now. We are 13th now. And the guys above me are just pulling ahead so fast. So if you haven't voted yet, you can do so every day. 10 votes. I'll put a link to that below as well. Goodness, there are going to be so many links below. Wow. Am I making a mistake here? I'm probably not going to remember all of them. But there will be links below. Check them out. And give me a vote if you've got some spare. If you don't, then that's fine too. Just check my campaign page out and enjoy it. There you go. It's sad, but I might not make the top 10. But I'm still very proud. I'm like third or fourth in the gaming category. Although there aren't really very many gamers there. There's that one guy. That one guy on top who's got like 10 times more votes than everyone else. But still, a lot of fun. I'm enjoying King of the Web. Well, hello, boy. Are you back? Look how dirty he is now. He was lying in the grass. He says it's too hot out there, Daddy. I'm back to lie on my cool couch. Yes. Sleepy eyes, hey? Oh, it's totally sleepy eyes. Nero wants a nap-nap. Always wanting a nap-nap. There you go. Oh, it's nice. Oh, it's very good. Under the chin a little bit. Oh, it's quite nice. There you go. Okay. You can just pretend that you gave Nero a rub there. That rub was from everyone watching this video, my boy. Was it good? Was it better than the normal rubs that you get? Probably. Probably.
Yes, I think so. So, that's it for this video. Check back here soon for more. I'm not sure what's going up next. I really don't know. I'm in the dark. I'm going to probably record Minecraft now, do some StarCraft news, and some other stuff too. So check back here for those videos. Most importantly though, happy signing up for the Guild Wars 2 beta. And happy hoping for the best. You know, you might get in. You might not want to get in, because I heard a few people that actually don't want to play the game, they're not so keen for it. Maybe they're playing Star Wars, maybe they're still playing WoW, maybe they're just waiting for Diablo. And if that's the case, then that's fine. But if you are shooting for the beta, then happy that.